A fortnight after Queensland's bushfire disaster began, property owners are still tallying the cost. Graziers and growers have lost stock and crops and are warning the recovery could take years as a political blame game heats up.
David Marland is surveying the damage on his Cowpower property northwest of Bundaberg. Thousands of hectares of burnt out wasteland. He runs 1,500 head of cattle here. Some perished.
We've seen cows with big bags of milk. So we think they've lost calves.
Yeah.
And now the challenge to feed those that survived.
You can see by the landscape here there's not a great lot of feed here.
Mr. Marland says roaring westerlies and searing heat fanned the blaze that day. But he says a heavy fuel load made it worse because he wasn't able to do a hazard reduction burn earlier in the season.
Could have had earlier burns and we could have limited the damage that was done. I still haven't got the permit.
The federal and state LNP believe Queensland's vegetation management laws exacerbated the recent fire emergency. It'll form part of a federal parliamentary inquiry announced this morning.
They are just choosing to play cheap politics with this when I was focused on saving people's lives.
The Premier says climate change is to blame, not state laws.
There have been no changes to what farmers can do in preparation for fires in terms of tracks and fire breaks under the vegetation management laws.
At Baffle Creek, dragon fruit grower Warren Cartwright is also counting the costs.
Bloody disaster. Exactly. Everything burnt out.
About 80% of the crop was lost as flames as high as 17 metres tore through neighbouring trees.
Scary, because it was roaring like a bloody freight train.
He's trying to salvage what's left.
Maybe next year we might see fruit on them again, but if not, it'd be probably a couple of years.
The emergency is over for now, but local fire brigades are still patrolling.
They all need medals, seriously. And we will be a stronger community after this.
Getting on with recovery. Sarah Jane Bell, ABC News, Cowpower.